about the politicization of the body, especially in the context of feminism discourse and your present dissertation.
Okay, so I in fact talked about the how the people, I mean how the these poets use the image of body in order to, you know, come up with their politics of nativism. But I deliberately did not use the term feminism because there has been an ongoing debate both within and outside the Native American academic community about the use of the term feminism, because, you know, a vast majority of Native American poets believe that the term feminism is not apt to, you know, talk about their politics, because it has got that imperial baggage, it has got that colonial baggage of white Eurocentrism in the term feminism. So again, we can see that some people, of course, agree with this with the usage of the term feminism, but most of them do not agree. Now, the poet Rose herself has stated in one of her interviews that when I am on the Hopi reservation, I am not a feminist, but when I am outside, I am a feminist. So you can see that you cannot, in fact, tag a person when it comes to the Native American writers, I mean, women or as writers or anybody, activists, as a feminist or anti-feminist. They keep on shifting their positions as and accordingly, because they believe that the term feminism is a limiting term. So they want to have a more fluid, more dynamic kind of notion with regard to their,
Okay. I think you have started off, or you have inaugurated your thesis,
yes,
with a statement by Craig Womack.
Yes, yes.
Okay. That itself is enough to speak a lot about the Native American tribal literary traditions. So,
yes.
The major general epistemological features of Native American or the tribal literary traditions.
Okay. So, what distinctly marks the Native American, thought system, their belief system, apart from the let's say the Western Eurocentric notions or system, epistemological system, is that there is a great sense of collectivism and a feeling of togetherness, a community as such in Native American writings. And the Native American writings, you can see that the land or the earth or the nature itself is considered as sacred in Native American tradition. So that is why they find people find their identity, their individuality intrinsically related to the land or the place or the tribe to which they belong. So a separation, you know, that is what happened when these people were displaced, when various relocation policies were initiated by the federal government, because they found that they are not they have been displaced from their lands, and so that they feel that they started feeling